casting a movie, it's like putting together the perfect dinner party. You not only have to have the right people at the table, you have to make sure to have the right people sitting next to each other. Sometimes I get so passionate about my casting choice that I have to get up on the table and fight for the right actors so that the team can see a new vision.
Escaped from the off-world colonies 2 weeks ago. 6 replicants.
I'm lost.
I need you, Deck. I need the old Blade Runner.
Now let's go get your daughter.
Henry Thomas had us all in tears behind the camera when he did a screen test for Elliot in E.T.
I'll be right here.
Indiana Jones. Always knew someday you'd come walking back through my door.
I was lucky enough to work with Steven Spielberg on 5 films. Instead of doing the traditional audition process, I paired up actors and had them come in and cook a recipe together. Now, if that's not chemistry, I don't know what is. I found Ki-Hui Kwan, who played Short Round, at an open call in Chinatown in Los Angeles. He came with his brother, and he wasn't even going to audition, and we talked him into it.
They are there, everywhere, if only you see them, find your way.
Hi.
The Preacher in Footloose was written as a Paul Newman-esque, charismatic man.
Dancing, there's no dancing, right? It's illegal.
It's your bag.
These albums, and turn them into one big, fiery, cinder-like rat!
I thought, time to think outside the box. I had just seen John Lithgow in De Palma's Blowout as a serial killer and a transsexual in Garp.
My name is Ren McCormick.
I really fought for him to play this part.
Kirby, how are you?
I'm obsessed, thank you very much.
I've worked with so many actors at the beginning of their careers and have watched them evolve into full-blown movie stars.
Pretty in pink, isn't she? Pretty in pink, isn't she?
What's these claws up front?
Don't pick.
When I was doing The Crush, I found Alicia Silverstone before she played Cher in Clueless. To find a young Lolita at her age with such sensuality was quite a challenge. Spitfire Grill was my first real indie, and it opened me up to the world of independent films. I co-produced the film, and it won the Sundance Audience Award.
As long as you hold someone in your heart, Charlie, you can never lose them. Ever.
Casting Brad Bird's first feature film, The Iron Giant, was a real eye-opener. Casting voiceover is so different than casting on-screen talent. It really gave me an appreciation for acting primarily with your voice and how it can make or break an animated film.
You are who you choose to be.
We'll be right back. I had to recast Freaky Friday roughly 2 weeks before we started shooting because Annette Bening left because of scheduling conflicts. Within my career, I realized I've been lucky enough to be a part of casting films that are iconic, that resonate with an entire generation. At this point in my career, I've gone from watching movies in the theaters to watching them on my phone. I am so excited to be working with a new generation of filmmakers, and I embrace the change.